Coach, thank you. We are over 4,000 miles away from where you're seated in Orlando as we come to you from the European home of the NFL, London, England, and Wembley Stadium. Coming up, another edition of the NFL International Series, and it should be a good one, between the Philadelphia Eagles and the Jacksonville Jaguars. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line.
Get him. Get him. Just go. You suck.
It'll wind up being a loss of two, and that'll make it second and 12. Well, that play was doomed right from the start.
They just about ran into every defender on that one, didn't he? It felt like everyone got a piece of that tackle.
Can't run on me. Why would you freaking run three plays in a row? Two plays in a row, sorry.
The influence on this game is now coming from those hybrid-type players. In this case, strong safety, not worried about coming with the pass. What a play on the run.
Oh, get him.
Yeah, forget the pregame introductions. Introduced himself with authority on that play.
An Eagle first down there, Winston, and the names that end in TZ.
His position, and he's listed as a tight end, but he certainly doesn't run like one, and that's what we're seeing more and more coming into the league. Those guys who can run, make plays after the catch, and gain that additional yardage.
And using that speed there to turn it into a pretty nice little game. And the
can't
run. He gets maybe a couple up to the 38.
Got only 2 yards on that inside blitz. Come on.
I think he was lucky to get
come
a couple
on.
Yards out of it. Those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
Again, they'll run it. Again, it's scores.
Can't run. Why would you run two plays in a row again? That's twice that you try to run.
Losing a yard on the play, and that'll make it third down.
Two plays in a row.
Watching the game, they may want to pile that one away. See how fast the free safety closed to make that play?
Damn it. Needed to get that. Come on.
Doesn't work. Good reaction there defensively, and it'll be fourth down. On is the punt team now as this one's sent away. And this will be taken at the 13.
Damn it.
A good return there. Call it 13 yards. And the Jaguars go on offense. First down and 10. Bortles leads the Jags up first and 10 at their own 26.
Come on, get a cup. Damn it. I didn't get that much.
Not much happening there on first down.
Thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
Now Bortles throwing on second down. Austin Seferian Jenkins has it.
Good job.
Shy of the 40 at the 35. Bortles to the former Jets, Seferian Jenkins for the Jags' first down.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to. Pick up a first down.
Come on, hike the damn ball. Why would you go? Why did I do that?
It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Forget about finding a lane there. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. Probably fortunate he's able to hold on to the football.
Bortles to throw on second down. Eluding the pressure right. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly...
Good job.
But a nice little game.
Let's go.
7 yards on the play, and it's third and short.
Okay, I mean, I should run with the... Yeah, much called, but whatever.
They try their best to find something open, but they took away every personality, every angle, and shut the play down.
Here's Bortles to throw.
Dive right there. Let's go. Get to the freaking line.
Here on this third down, they could run it or pass it. Either one was chose to try and get it through the air, and they run successful.
First and 10. Here's Bortles.
Damn it.
Able to intercept it. That's what they like to have held on to on this first drive. Instead, second down.
Tremendous coverage there. Just did not catch the football and complete the interception. But what do they say all the time? If he had really good hands, he'd be playing offense.
Back to the air on second down. It's Bortles. Buying time to his left. Now he's going to... And this is...
Good catch!
Touchdown, Jacksonville.
Let's go!
45 yards. And the Jags have taken the early lead. So a one-handed grab in the end zone. Nothing much more rewarding than that for a guy catching it. Back here with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. We've had the kickoff to begin the first quarter. Now it's time for the second quarter kickoff, as we'll see one following the score on the final play before break. The Eagles offense back out onto the field and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. He wins.
The guy's man complete.
Damn it.
That one goes for 36 yards. So the defense blitzed. A nice job picking that up, completing the pass.
And how in sync was the quarterback in his center on that play? They saw the blitz, made the appropriate calls, got the line engaged, because now they know there are going to be extra guys coming in.
Okay, that's
so
good.
Their assignments down that and kept them from it. And he's able to step up in the pocket and fire
come
one
on
out for a really good strike.
Coach, get the ball back.
Coach's staff doing a good job upstairs. They'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again. Go play action and hit them over the top.
Sideline throw. It's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes inbounds. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
Let's go.
If you're running out route, it's
stop him right here.
You end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there? You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tap.
Good job.
Picking it up and making a catch.
Losing 2 yards that time, and now it's fourth down.
They tried to run right into the teeth of the defense on third down, but looked like those teeth were pretty sharp.
Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. And it's complete. They're going to get the first.
No way.
They stop him a few yards shy.
Let's go.
The fake doesn't work out.
Why would you fake it right there? You are an idiot.
Attempt to begin with, so the fake you might have known was somewhat of a possibility. Credit to the defense, though. They weren't fooled.
You're right, they weren't fooled, and they were in a position of having to play it both ways.
Damn it, I should have threw it.
Get there for the
wait. Damn it.
Derek Barnett in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8. Defensive end gets in there that time. They were in a 4-3. What's the responsibility of the ends versus the tackles there, Charles?
Well, most of the time when you talk about the ends, they're your pass rushers. They're the guys.
Can you block? You freaking suck at blocking.
Usually more of the run stuffing variety. But the way this game is advanced, you're wanting a little bit of everything out of all of your guys. But let's just go ahead and break it down and make it simple. The guy who's the right defensive end versus a right-handed quarterback, that's the blind side. He's going after the quarterback.
Well, this is taken in. It's complete.
Let's go!
Takes it all the way down to the 32. A big play there. Bortles to lead. 45 yards.
Sometimes it's designed, and sometimes you just have to know when to leave the pocket and move and make something happen. Now that play is able to get on the run.
Come on. Take the damn ball.
Bortles on the give to Fournette. And he's immediately there. A minute 58 to go in this first half of play. My good friend Charles and I right back at you.
You start freaking blocking. Freaking suck at that.
Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. Paul bringing it in. And he'll be a little
travel shy of the 25 here, the 26-yard line. Come on.
6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Here we go. There we go. That's the play I wanted. That's what you should be doing every time. Fucking block.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better...
Actually, I shouldn't... I'm running a... They're going to stop me. Whatever, I don't really care.
They'll try and run for it with Fournette.
No, they didn't. Wow. You suck.
Nice pickup of six there to get him closer to the end zone, and it'll be second and goal.
Pass it right here.
Some power and some explosiveness just about got him into the end zone.
On second down, here's Bortles.
You're letting him come right at me. Why don't you freaking block just once?
He gets him for a loss of five.
When you're this close to the goal line, you gotta expect pressure from the defense. So the ball's gotta come out fast. Gotta get out of his hands quicker.
Bortles now on third and goal.
Catch the damn ball.
On the clock. So they won't get a touchdown, but here's a chance to at least get three to end the first half. From the left hash, a chip shot here. And Lambeau will put this...
Thank you. And good job.
That drive took him inside the 10.
Might just do a Gregor kickoff.
Yeah, I like how you did that. Give a little tip of the cap to the stop troops. Because they didn't give up a touchdown in that situation, right? Made him kick the field goal. And yeah, points went against them. But that feels a whole lot better running off the field.
Time running short.
Okay, good.
Simply take a knee and that should do it. So we reach halftime here in a 10-point game. As it's time, there you have it. Halftime quickly over. Third quarter.
I'm not doing halftime. It's stupid.
As they say here in London, all to play for as we are back underway in the second half. That'll be taken in the end zone.
Take it out.
And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30.
Good job.
Out come the Jaguars now as they'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire...
Come on, block like you did earlier.
Here's what we think they're...
Can't
going to do
bet.
In the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys. But be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see it kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets them to second and four.
Third quarter, and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out.
I did a quick pass right there. I didn't mean to do that.
Incomplete.
Well, this at least is the right idea. I think they've got to get the tight end more involved.
He had just one target in the first half. Incomplete for the first target in the second half.
Yeah, should not stop them at all from going back to him, though. Find him. Find him.
Bortles steps away to his left.
How did it...
Nearly the pick they needed.
Damn it.
They would have loved one there, but
I don't get how that didn't go up.
Pretty lucky to get the football back. Had his target out there waving the arms, saying I'm open, but...
Do not go in the end zone.
Always about defensive back's hands.
Let's go. It didn't go in the end zone.
Opportunities, you get over anxious, and you start to think about taking it away and going the other way instead of focusing and catching the ball.
Good catch.
The Eagles now as they get set for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance really to set the tone here in quarter three.
They can really take charge, can't they? And
safety. Let's go.
He's taken down for a safety. Well, I think you can go ahead and give your punter an assist on that one. Pinned him deep, and the defense comes through with 2 points.
You're exactly right, partner. This was all set up by
Get to the... Good job. Shut out, you piece of shit.
At some point, we're going to get it through our heads. Special teams, special teams, special teams. The spark that often wins games.
Bortles leads the Jags up first and 10 at their own 42.
I should have kept it.
Malcolm Jenkins up to make the stop.
And when the defense wins and gives up no yardage on a running play, that's something they can build on and carry themselves forward throughout the game.
He'll rifle this one deep right side.
What just happened there? Damn it.
Could have been a game changer there in this second half. Instead, it's third down.
Oh, man, that was close.
Give it to...
Opportunity to change momentum. Big play right in his hands.
Hike the ball.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense if that fell harmlessly to the ground. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought
down. I'm going to go for it. I don't really care.
Five, but it'll lead to a fourth down.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
Bortles in the offense remains put on the field. They're going to go for it on fourth. They do go for it. It's Bortles. And he finds the
Let's go!
And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. Fourth down, no problem. 19 yards that time, and now it's first and 10.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players. Came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You get better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies.
Come on. You need to start blocking some more. Like, come on. It's like I can't even do one running play.
Little time to actually find a place to run the football. It's almost like the defense is there on the handoff.
Throwing now is Bortles. Dumps it off to Fournette. And brought down, but not
good job.
Inside the 25. Down Jacksonville. The passing game looking sharp on this drive for the Jags. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer.
I'm going to run it again.
Fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
Oh, no.
I'm not.
That was incomplete. That was so incomplete. Damn it. That was a running play.
Fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does where a quarterback has to slide and find open space to throw.
It's a short one here, complete to his tight end.
Come on.
And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end.
I don't really care. I just want... a first down. Just get a first down.
In, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
Now Bortles dancing to his left. He can run for it and he will. And down.
Let's go.
15, shy of the 10 yards there. Good enough for a Jags first down.
Let's face it. You can run the route tree as many times as you want. Get in sync. Practice it. Do all those things. But once you get to game speed, it doesn't always time up quite that well. That one goes incomplete.
Throwing on first down is Bortles. Flush to his right. And
oh, come on!
Line,
just...
Bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far at second down.
Just let's face it, perfection is something we all chase. Whether it's playing this game or whatever we do,
hard to attain, but that's what they were searching for as that pass goes incomplete. Escaping the pressure right. That's complete. Right around the eight.
Let's go. Hurry up, hurry up.
The reception good for seven. It's third down. They'll try and run for it with Cornell. And he's going to be stopped here for no gain. And that's going to take it.
Can't even block. Like,
welcome back now to London. And before this fourth and three play, we're going to get whistles and a timeout. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. And with things looking pretty good on the scoreboard, they're going to keep the offense out there and go for it here on fourth. They come out here in the eye. They'll try and move fullback to handle. And not only did he not get in the end zone, he didn't get the first.
Damn it!
They'll get neither the
I shouldn't even went for it.
And it'll be a turnover on downs.
Come on.
They'll begin the drive with the Giants. And an alley to run. And he's taken down, but able to get this up to the 20-yard line. They got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs.
Well, definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
Wentz now on first down. Screen pass to Scholes.
What an idiot. Why would you catch that ball?
He lost nine there. That's really going to set
it's a loss of nine. Why would you catch that?
So critical, and you figure may only get one more
like, seriously.
So a touchdown's imperative on this drive.
It is, but you also have to think to yourself in play calling.
I should have been there.
Second down pass play there.
He would have been gone if he caught that.
It was definitely one that he would love to have back. I wonder what's going through his head. I wonder what kind of mind game he's playing with himself to get himself back on track. Because a lot of guys, that's what they do. They have little triggers that when the mechanics are off, if they make a bad throw, that they go to
thank you.
To get themselves back.
Good job coming up. Stop him right here, then the game's over.
You cannot write these guys off just yet. Not with a quarterback like that under center.
You mean it actually crossed your mind with him running the team that you could actually maybe write this game off?
Not yet.
Not a chance. Not with him. We've seen it too many times.
And you didn't stop him. Why didn't he? Why would you leave him wide open like that?
The time to pull out the stops is now, and they
no, he was going to him.
Even though this offense doesn't have a single point to its name, they're not totally out of this game yet. A touchdown here, they could be in business.
And how about that last play? Now that no
right through the offensive line.
Let's
go.
Leading the surge there, he drops in for a loss of six.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
In a blink of an eye, that happened fast and a big sack. And the pressure gets to him again. Dante,
you suck, Carson Wentz.
Drop him, and sacks on first and second downs are going to lead to a third and long.
Remember, throughout my career,
third and 21, 2:35 left. Let's go.
They put themselves in a great spot with this big lead.
Do not give up anything.
These have to be salivating. It is pin your ears back time indeed.
You're lucky.
The defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Now Wentz, gotta have this one. These guys
left him wide open again.
Taking it right down Broadway. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Zach Ertz, 62 yards. There the Eagles are back without a score.
I'm not sure win-win is the proper term here, but it certainly felt like it. They got the touchdown they needed. But if I'm on the defensive side of the ball, okay, you got the touchdown. touchdown, but it sure took you a long time.
Yeah, because offensively there, you're probably hoping for a 1 to 5 play drive. That one ate up a little more time than they were hoping.
You're exactly right. And if you have that 1 to 5 play drive, you actually build up momentum and even more hope when they had to slob their way downfield. They got the touchdown.
Get out of my way!
Yeah, you know, it doesn't feel right. Exactly.
I would have been gone if you didn't get in my freaking way.
And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. After the touchdown we just saw, we have a brand new ball game. And now look at the situation. You got plenty of time on the clock. Defensively, they have 3 timeouts. So do you run the football here or do you throw it?
I think you have that full conversation with your offense.
Now he's hit and Bortles.
No way. I freaking threw that.
Recovered. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion.
I threw that. I had to have. I think my hand was going forward. I threw that. Are you freaking serious?
He'll look to throw. He's gonna flip that out to the flat. It's complete. Nothing on that one. It'll be second.
I'm gonna call a timeout because I need to do something.
So another stop. 1:50 left in the football game. Had the complete
touchdown,
but for no gain. Stopped right at the line, so it's 2nd and 10. Offensive line wasn't set. There's the flag, and 5 yards back they go.
Quarterback has to look around and make sure that his team is ready to go.
Okay, come on.
Quarterbacks go faster than
2nd and 15.
So loss of 5, and it'll be
let's go.
Down. So
2nd and 15.
In the wrong direction. 2nd and 15. They'll look to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And he can't correct.
Good job.
That would have wrapped it up if he'd been able to hold on. Instead, it brings up 3rd down. They took their shot from the end zone, almost cost them.
And he made the
I'm not going away.
But boy, it looked like he had a chance to come down with the football. If he does that, this thing is over. Instead, he leaves him out there with another chance.
Let's go.
Now on 4th down, we've got a whistle here and a timeout as they stop it prior to what will be an important 4th down.
Okay, stop him right here.
He's back to throw.
Good job.
Incomplete. They had to go for it with
let's go.
Time remaining, and the Jaguars are going to take possession here of the turnover on downs. So now let's reset here, Charles. They do have 2 timeouts left, so they can stop the clock twice. This one's not quite over yet.
No, and what you're doing on defense, you're going to use both timeouts, obviously. But you've got to call defenses are going to force the issue early, meaning you want that play over fast. You don't want to give them time to dance around in the backfield or run a wide sweep that'll take off time. Blitz them, put pressure on them, make sure that play ends quickly so that you can go ahead and keep moving.
Sunday.
Come on.
On 2nd down, here's Yeldon. And he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line. And now we're going to get a timeout here.
Now they're going to get the ball back.
Coming up, here's 3rd and 10.
I would expect to see some
No, they're not.
And the blitz does come. This is Yeldon on the dump off.
They got it. I think I got it. Damn it. No, I'm not going for it.
But that completion put them in really great range. What do we have now? 4th and inches?
Ah, shit.
You know what I would do here?
You would always go for it.
I should have left a little bit more time run off.
Carson Wentz, along with his offense, heading back out there for their next possession.
No deep passes.
If you're a quarterback in the NFL, this is the spot that you love.
You've been dreaming of it since you were a kid, playing in the backyard or the front yard, wherever, when you went through those imaginary situations.
Damn it. Come on.
It's real, though. What practice have you put in since the OTAs, the mini camps, let's preseason camp, sequence of play?
Oh, shit.
Get out of bounds, save your timeouts, move the ball downfield, get your team in position to win the game.
I couldn't move this freaking player. Why couldn't I move? What?
And he'll be down deep into Jacksonville territory. A big play there on the catch and run.
I told you, no big plays and you give up a big play. Are you serious?
And he'll spike it with exactly 30 seconds now left on the clock.
Oh, yes! He couldn't have. Did he get it? Come on. He didn't get it. I don't think he get it. Catched it. Let's go.
So they went to the booth to see if that was a touchdown, and they decided it will not be a touchdown. 6 points off the board. They're going to give it to Sproles, and he will not get there.
Okay, good. I didn't get the. He didn't get the 2 points.
It'll remain a one-point game. To return it is Corey Grant.
Okay.
Just start their drive. Just pass the 30.
Just get the field goal.
And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. They only need a field goal. Obviously, the clock a huge factor. They'll be watching that. What do they need to do here, Charles?
Your sequence of plays has to get you out of bounds. Completions, get out of bounds, gain some yardage. Then when the clock hits 7 seconds or left, now you get a decision. Are you in field goal range?
It's caught inside the 25. A big play there. Bortles to lead.
Okay.
47 yards.
Hike the ball. Hike the ball.
One final try now for Bortles. Sliding out of the pocket. Interesting final chapter to this proverbial book here in this one, because
I said, it's a pretty. J.J. Watt is suckish now. He sucks now. Okay, who gets the ball first? Ooh, we do. Let's go.
National Football League brings us to Gillette Stadium in Foxborough, Mass. Today it's the opener of a new NFL season between the Houston Texans and the New England Patriots.
You are so freaking slow.
That's the 20 to the 22 yard line.
I don't even know who's on the Patriots anymore. Whatever, I don't really care. Who really cares?
On first down, Brady. Oh, he's gonna take a shot right away. And it pops free. The collision.
What?
There,
catch the. No, no. What? No.
I love them because this is a group that's so.
I'm gonna quit this one and I'm gonna do a new one. You do like Carson Wentz or something.
I got so much beef, I can barely sleep. Paranoia got me losing.
Kick your season off by starting your first game.
I'm playing on the knees all day. If you feel frightened when I up it, I'm bad company, bad for your company. Bad company, bad for your company. In the scheme as it takes you come for me. Got in the scheme as it takes.
Select the team you want to join.
They don't want no beef. When they say they got beef, they don't want to eat. If they say they want, they don't want no steam for the.
Start your season with recommended settings.
Had a bachelor's degree. He was selling.
Only a couple more minutes because I do not want to do this past 8 o'clock because that's SmackDown Live's time. It's my time to watch SmackDown Live.
Start the regular season by selecting your season goal.
They don't want no problems with me. My got good. I know I bought them. Might not hit a bad, bad.
Start your week by meeting your season goal comes with higher rewards.
Dog shades, too much. Got to really see them. Acting brand new like I don't see them. When I do, put them both. Going. Give me room, only four players close, do the most, don't they? Bad company, that's bad for your company. Bad company, that's bad for your company. Bad cow disease, now you in the tunnel. Tuck underneath my new dunker.
I can't wait for the new NFL Madden to come out.
An AFC West showdown right out of the gate. EA Sports coverage of the NFL takes us to the Mission Valley area of beautiful San Diego, California. Today, we start the new season with an AFC West division battle right out of the gate between the Kansas City Chiefs and the Los Angeles Chargers. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20, call it the 21-yard line. Now a play fake here on first down.
Sack. Eat my fucking dutch, you piece of shit.
Leading the surge there, he drops him for a loss of six.
Brandon, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I'm going to go to screen soon.
Good job.
Second down throw. Can't knocked away and incomplete.
In most pass defenses, the guy playing safety has the ability to roam free and try and go to the football. But when you're a man, you've got to cover just like a guy playing out on the corner. Lock up on the receiver.
Eric Berry. Attaboy. Let's go.
We've watched this a long time, and I still don't believe we get it. Third and long, why are you calling play action?
Yeah, because they're not going to bite defensively, right?
No, not at all. I did have a coach explain to me years ago that for some teams, that's how they have to deal with pass protection and their line blocking. But to me, it seems silly.
Yeah, well, they're silly, and it leads to a play action.
Ah.
They'll call that a six.
I should have spun.
He got all of that one. And it's Chiefs football, first and 10. Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their own 37. They go play action here on first down. And no, incomplete. Boy, they took a shot there on the first play, trying to start it out with a bang. But it's second down.
Okay, this is the last play because I do not want to go past my time when it's time to work.
Look for him to try it again later.
He's going to loft one deep left side here. So the long attempt falls innocently to the ground.
One more.
Sure, that pass was incomplete. They made an attempt to get a big one downfield. But that's okay because the second part of that is if you don't get the completion, at least you've told the defense you're trying to stretch them out a little bit, and they may have to change accordingly.
Throwing is Mahomes on third.
I'm gonna restart this game tomorrow so I can do it. Or maybe I won't start this game.